Good morning, students. Let's learn today exercise 8.2, question number 4. Fill in the blanks. Now see, here blank boxes are given. We have to fill that blank boxes. Okay. Now see, here this given fraction is 3/8. Okay. Is equal to, see again I am writing here this number. Blank box upon 64. 3/8 is equal to blank box upon 64. So now 64. See, 8 words are 64. 8 are 64. If you will divide for 64 by 8, you will get 8. So 8 are 64. If you will multiply by 8 for this denominator, you will get 64. See, 8 are 64. Now we are multiplying for denominator by 8. So we have to multiply by 8 for the numerator also. See, here I will multiply by 8 for the numerator also. So what answer I will get here? 3 8s are 24. So what it will come in this blank box? 24. Okay. So what we got here? 24. See, 64 is given. 8 8s are 64. So we multiply by 8. For the denominator, same way we have to multiply by 8 for the numerator also. So 3 8s are 24. Now this will take. Now given fraction is 3/8. Okay. Is equal to the. Now don't take this. We got this answer. Now take this 36 upon this box. Okay. 36 upon this box. Now 3. For 3, with which number we will multiply, then we get 36. 3 12s are 36. Now you will say, madam, how you got? See, if we do not understand what we have to do, for 36 divide by 3. See, numerator is given here. Here denominator we have to find. Numerator is given. So here at numerator place, which number is given? 3. And here 36. So for this 36, start dividing by 3. 3 1s are 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. 6 will come down. 3 2s are 6. Okay. So what we got? 12. 12 we got. So if I will multiply by 12, for 3 I will get 36. 12 3s are 36. So we got 3 multiplied by 12. What we got? 3 multiplied by 12 we got 36. Okay. So now here for numerator we multiply by 12. So what we are going to do? We are going to multiply by 12 for the denominator to get the equivalent fraction. Okay. So multiply by 12 for the denominator also. So 12 8s are 96. 12 8s are 96. So what answer will get here? 96. Okay. So what we got here? 96. Understood? Now let's solve next example. See, our given fraction is 7/9. Let's take first number 21 upon this blank box. Okay. So now, see here, numerator is 7 and here numerator is 21. And it is shown equal. Means these are equal. These are equivalent fraction. Okay. So now 7 words are 21. If I will multiply by 3 for the 7, I will get 21. 7 3s are 21. So same way, what I am going to do? For denominator also I will multiply by 3. Then I will get the equivalent fraction. Okay. So 9 3s are 27. So what we got? 9 3s are 27. So here what we call? 27. Okay. So now this number we got. Now let's take next. 7/9. Okay. Is equal to this blank box upon 45. Okay. So now see, in this given question, see 7/9 is given fraction and here now we have to find the numerator. Denominator is given. Okay. So 9 words are 45. 9 5s are 45. 9 5s are 45. Means if I will multiply by 5 for 9, I will get 45. So now I am multiplying by 5 for the denominator. So I will multiply by 5 for the numerator also to get equivalent fraction. So 7 5s are 35. 7 5s are 35. So 35 will come here. Okay. Okay. Now next, take this fraction as it is. 7 upon 9. This is ratio. How? What we can say for this ratio? 7 is to 9. And this is given fraction. 7 upon 9. Now 7 upon 9 is the given fraction, and this is. See, don't take now this both we got. Now take third one, 56 upon this blank box. Okay. Now, see, this is given fraction 7 upon 9. And this is 56 upon blank box is given. Means numerator is given. So let's see the 7 ones are 56. 7 eights are 56. 7 eights are 56. If we will multiply by 8 for 7, we will get 56. So now what we have to do to get equivalent fraction for denominator also we have to multiply by 8. How we get the equivalent fraction for numerator and denominator we have to multiply by same number. Okay. To get equivalent fraction what we have to do, we have to multiply for numerator and for denominator with the same number. Okay. So 9 8s are 72. So what we got here? 72. Okay. Solve question number 5. Fill in the blanks if in each case one variable varies directly as the other. Okay. One variable varies directly as the other. Now see here given x is to y. Means x upon y. What it is given? 1.2 upon 36. See, first one will take 1.2 upon 36. It is x is to y. Means x upon y. Okay. So what it is? 1.2 upon 36. Now next is 3.6 upon blank box. Okay. Okay. Now see. 1.2. Without decimal point, think this which number it is. Without decimal point. 12. And without decimal point, this is 36. So 12 is a 36. That we know. So let's check. 1.2 multiplied by 3 will get 3.6 or not. 3 2s are 6. 3 1s are 3. See now, here after decimal point, here one digit. So for answer before one digit, give the decimal point. So if we will multiply by 3, for 1.2 we will get 3.6. Okay, so what we will do? See here. Then now, so for 1.2, which number we multiplied, then we got 3.6 for 1.2. Just now you saw for 1.2 we multiplied by 3, then we got 3.6. So for 1.2 we will multiply by 3. If we will multiply by 3 for 1.2, then we will get 3.6. So now what we are going to do with the same number, we will multiply for the denominator also. So for 36 multiple by 3, 3 6s are 18, 3 3s are 9 and 1, 10. So what we will get? 108. So what we got in the place of this blank box? 108. Okay. Now this is given fraction 1.2 upon 36. Okay. So here I will solve. So fraction is 1.2 upon 36. Okay. And here we have to find the numerator. See, this is blank box and at denominator place there is 260. Which number it is given? 216. So what we will do? We'll check now. See, for 1.2 upon 36. Now to get 216, for 36 by which number we will multiply? 36 words are 260. If you will not understand, you can divide and find. Or there is one easy way. See, for 36 which number we will multiply? We'll check. 36 means 1 plus is 6. Here 1 plus is 6. So see the 6 table. 6 is a 36. Means if we will multiply by 6, we will get the 1 plus 6. Okay. So let's check. Just we'll check. 6 is a 36. 6 3s are 18. 18 plus 3, 21. So we got 216. Okay. So for 36, we will multiply by 6. What we will get? 216. Okay, how you got 216? If we will multiply for the 36 by 6, we will get 216. Or we can do one thing. We don't know by which number we have to multiply. What we will do? We can do one thing. For 216, we will divide by 36. If you will divide by 36, you can write the table of 36. Now 36 6s are 216. Okay. So by which number we have to multiply for 36? By 6. Okay. So we are multiplying by 6 for the denominator. Same way we have to multiply by 6 for the numerator also. Now 1.2 multiplied by 6. 6 2s are 12. 6 1s are 6 and 1, 7. Now see, here after decimal point, here 1 digit. So for answer before 1 digit, give the decimal point. So what it will come? 7.2. What will get answer? 7.2. So here what it will come? 7.2. Okay, so here you can write 7.2. We have to find this blank box. Now, this blank box we have to find. We got 7.2. So write here 7.2. Okay. So write here 7.2. Let's solve question number 6. The timetable given below gives pair for values of the variable x and y. Okay. First one, show that one variable varies directly as the other. See, first one I will solve here. Show that one variable varies directly as the other. Now see, this is x upon y. X upon y is equal to 1 upon 8. Okay, 1 upon 8 already it's given. 1 upon 8. Now let's take x upon y is equal to 2 upon 16. X upon y is equal to 2 upon 16. Now if you will do the lowest term for this, what it will get? See, 2 1s are 2, 2 8s are 16. So what you are going to get? 1 upon 8. Okay, if you will take x upon y is equal to 4 upon 32. 4 upon 32. Now do the lowest term for this. 4 1s are 4, 4 8s are 32. So what we got? 1 upon 8. Okay, so since all the given pairs of values of x and y have same ratio, so what you will write here? Since all the pairs, here also 1 is to 8. 1 upon 8. Okay, 1 upon 8 means what is the ratio? 1 is to 8. You can write only 1 upon 8 even though okay 1 is to 8. That is also correct. Okay, so now let's solve next one, third one example. What it is given? Find the missing values. Now these are here box is blank, this box is blank, this box is blank. So missing values we have to find. Here there is no value, so we have to find these values. Okay, now see, x is 2y, what is given ratio? 1 upon 8. So 1 upon 8 is equal to the, here blank box is given. Okay, blank box upon 24. Okay, blank box upon 24. Blank box upon 24. Okay, so now see here, 1 upon 8. 8 words are 24. 8 threes are 24. So here I will multiply by 3, then I will get here 24. Okay, so for numerator also I will multiply by 3. Okay, so I will multiply by 3. So 1 threes are 3. So what we got? 3 upon 24. 24 already we have. So here what will come? Missing number, missing value 3. Okay, so here missing value is 3. Okay, now next what it is given in that? See, this is the first blank box. Okay, in third one only, x is to y. Now given ratio is 1 is to 8, 1 is to 8, 1 upon 8. And now next one, 11, and here blank box is given. Okay, fill in the blanks. Okay, missing values we have to find now. So here I will make the star for this to understand. This is the answer for first one, this is the answer for second blank box. Okay, now 1 upon 8 is equal to 11 upon which number will come? Now see, 1 upon 10. Write this fraction as it is. Okay. Here also this number take as it is. Okay. Now numerator is given. So now 1 words are 11. 1 11s are 11. If we multiply for 1 by 11, we get the answer 11. So same way for denominator also we have to multiply by 11. 11s are 88. So what will come in the place of this box? 88. So right here 88. Okay, so now next one, see here I am writing, third one, 1 upon 8 is equal to, see 1 upon 8 is equal to, now here numerator is not given, means we have to find the numerator, denominator is given. Okay, now see here 1 upon 8, write this number as it is. Here 1600, okay, 1600. Now by which number I will multiply here? For 8, then I will get 1600. Suppose I don't know by which number I will multiply. It is easy. You can multiply by 200. Okay. 8 twos are 16. But if you don't know, what you can do? For 1600, we will divide by 8. Then we will get here by which number we have to multiply. Okay. 8 twos are 16. 16 minus 16, 0. 0 will come down. 8 zeros are 0. Okay. This 0 will come down. 8 zeros are 0. So, if you will multiply by 200, okay, so for this number, for this 8, if you will multiply by 200, we get 1600. Now we are multiplying by 200 for the denominator. So we have to multiply by 200 for the numerator also. So 200 ones are 200. So what we got here? 200. Okay, so here we get 200. Okay, let's solve question number 7. If 80 kg of ration lasts for 15 days, see, I will write This is ration. Okay, 80 kg of ration. See, 80 kg of ration lasts for 15 days. And here I will write days. Okay, lasts for 15 days. Okay, how much ration is required to last for 75 days? Then for 75 days, how much ration is required? See, here I have given the question mark. How much ration is required to last for 75 days? So let ration, required ration be X. So let consider that it is X. Okay. How much ration is required to last for 75 days? So let this ration will consider X. Okay. X. You consider X. So what we have to do now here? See, these and these we will multiply. See, 8. These and these we will multiply. And these and these we will multiply. So, x multiplied by 15 is equal to 80 multiplied by 75. Okay. What we have to do? See, here given ration 80 kg for that 15 days. Then for 75 days, how much ration is required? Okay, so we have to find the ration for 75 days. How much ration is required? That we don't know. So let's consider x. So what we have to do? X multiplied by 15 and 80 multiplied by 75. Okay, so now here 15 is multiplied. If we will transfer to this side, then it will become divide. So x is equal to 80 multiplied by 75. Divided by 15. Okay, so x is equal to, now see here 15 ones are 15, 15 fives are 75. Okay, so now what we will get here? 80 multiplied by 5. So x is equal to 5 zeros are 0, 5 eights are 40. So 40. So ration, how much it is? 400 kg. So what we'll write? How much ration is required to last for 75 days? For 75 days, 400 kg ration is required. Okay, so what we'll write? For 75 days, 400 kg ration is required. Okay. Let's solve question number 8. 136 apples are shared by 24 students on a picnic. How many apples are shared by 3 students? Okay. 136 apples. See here I will write apples. So 136 apples shared by 24 students. And here students. Okay. 24 students on a picnic. 136 apples are shared by 24 students. Okay. On a picnic. How many apples are shared by 3 students? Then students written here. So 3 students. By 3 students, how many apples are shared? Okay. 136 apples shared by 24 students. Okay. So how many apples are shared by 3 students? Okay, means we have to find the number of apples. So let that number of apples be X. Okay, so here I will write X. Okay, we have to find the number of apples. Now, how many apples are shared by 3 students? We don't know how many apples, so let's consider X. Now, what we are going to do? See, these and these. We have to multiply. X multiplied by 24 is equal to these and these. Cross multiplication. 136 multiplied by 3. Okay. See these. X and 24. X multiplied by 24. 136 multiplied by 3. Okay. And in between equals. So now 24 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to that side, then it will become divide. So x is equal to 136 24 will divide here. Okay. So now x is equal to 136 multiplied by 3 upon 24. Now 3 ones are 3. 3 8s are 24. Okay. So what remained here? 136 divided by 8. Now let's divide for 136 by 8. See here I will show 136 divided by 8. 8 ones are 8. 13 minus 8. 5 will remain here. Okay, here 0. Then 6 will come down. 8 sevens are 56. 8 sevens are 56. So 17. So x is equal to 17. Okay, so what answer will get here? See, x is equal to 17. So what will write? How many apples are shared by 3 students? 17 apples. Let's solve question number 10. Two numbers are in the ratio 4:3. Their sum is 70. Find the numbers. See, two numbers are in the ratio. It is given in ratio 4:3. Their sum is given 70. Find the number. So let the number be. Let the numbers be. 4x and 3x respectively. Let the numbers be 4x. 4:3, no? So 4x and 3x respectively. Now what it is given? Their sum is. Now if you will do the sum of this, what is the sum of this? 4x plus 3x. How much it is? 7x. But what it is given? Their sum is 70. So what it will come? 7x is equal to 70. Okay. See, two numbers are in the ratio 4:3. So let the numbers be 4x and 3x respectively. Okay. Their sum is 70. Their sum what we got? 7x. But what it is given? It is given 70. So 7x is equal to 70. We have to write. Or we can do one thing. That is, see, what we have to do, let the number be 4x and 3x respectively. Their sum is 70. Their sum, so show like this, 4x plus 3x. Their sum is 70. This we have learned in equation lesson. Okay? Algebra. Introduction to algebra. How to write equation. Okay? Two numbers are in the ratio 4:3 and their sum is 70. Their sum. See that numbers be 4x and 3x respectively and their sum. Sum, so here we have to show the addition. Is 70. Is word is used for to show the equal. Okay, so is 70. Okay, so now 4x plus 3x, how much it is? 7x. 4 plus 3, 7. 7x is equal to 70. Now see here, 7x means 7 multiplied by x. 7x means 7 multiplied by x. Okay, so 7 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to this side, then it will become dy. Okay, 7 is here multiplied. We transfer to this side, then it is divided. Okay, so now x is equal to 70 divided by 7, 10. 7 tens are 70. So what we got? X is equal to 10. We got, see, we got x is equal to 10. Now what we have to find? Find the numbers. We have to find that number. So first number, what it is? 4x. Okay. First number is equal to 4x. So 4x means what? 4 multiple, see, first number is equal to 4x. So 4x means what? 4 multiple by x. Now x what we got? 10. So what is the first number? 4 tens are 40. So what we got? First number we got 40. And now second number, what is the second number? 3x. Okay. So 3 multiplied by x. X is 10. Okay. So 3 tens are 30. Okay. So what we got? First number and second number. First number we got 40. Second number we got 30. Okay.